two, three, funk it.
Good morning, good afternoon, sir. Yeah, this is the parking garage where we park the car.
Like you see a big Coca-Cola, we're gonna drink some Coca-Cola. Mommy and you are gonna drink Coca-Cola, and I'm gonna drink some blueberry juice.
That's right. So you guys, we are here at the Coca-Cola Center, as Lib just said, and we are going to monitor ourselves. We're not going to go berserk drinking all the beverages that we can, but we are going to have a great time.
We're going to try to, though.
This is Babe and I's third time being here, I believe, and Lib's second time being here. So this will be her second time of this trip. So we're so excited, and we are ready to go.
Let's go,
pumpkin. So we just got our city passes, and for those of you that may not know, a city pass is basically like a cheap version of tickets in order for you to be able to explore some of the attractions in any city. So this is our second time using the city passes, and basically I want to say Babe and I's were like $75. Thank you, pretty girl. And then Liv's was like $59 or something like that. And to even get here into the Coca-Cola, World of Coca-Cola, like the normal adult ticket is like $34, $35. So it's really worth it if you want to see some of the major attractions like we do. So we look forward to you guys seeing the other places we're gonna explore as the week goes on, okay?
Bye. All right guys, we're inside the Coca-Cola Museum. Got our little complimentary sodas. So we're gonna take a little taste of one right quick, see how you want some? Libby doesn't get any soda, but she can hold it as a souvenir. Always Coca-Cola.
What's the difference, babe, with the zero and the other one? Do you know?
Zero calories.
Oh, okay. Oh, that's the one I should have got.
Yeah. So we're about to go inside. Our tour begins in 8 minutes, so let's go.
Dallas is where? Guinea.
Dominican Republic.
And you? You're just standing here. 65 years. Until 1956, when it went up to the unheard of sum of 6 cents a glass. Highway robbery, mama. These beautiful cardboard.
Just finished watching the movie, guys, the 6 minute World of Coca-Cola movie. So we're about to do what?
We're about to go get some samples. We are ready to try some of everything from all over the world.
Yep.
We're excited.
It's our third time here.
Yeah.
And we are pretty much gonna leave in a sugar coma when we're done, because we sample everything.
Yeah, we're gonna try to get like small samples instead of a whole cup, you know. So pray for us.
She gotta speak for herself.
Well, I'm gonna be good, because I gotta, you know, Libby's gonna be watching. If she see me drinking a whole bunch, she's gonna want it. Daddy can do whatever, I guess.
That's true. All right, guys, see y'all later.
Peace.
He's
I know, he is, I agree.
He look like he has a scoliosis, baby.
Baby, how do we get to the beverages?
I don't even know.
We need to go to the beverages.
Goodbye, Bear. Liberty's
Bye,
not
Bear.
Feeling it.
Yeah, she's not interested.
She ain't interested. All right, let's go to the drinks, guys.
All right, come on.
Is it up here?
I don't think it's up here, babe. Let's ask these people.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
What do you think, Liberty? X-ray machine. I see where you get that from. This is the vault. This is like where we're gonna
look. Oh my goodness, we're on camera.
We this are. Is where we're gonna find out. We look right here, baby.
Oh, snap. We are on camera.
We're gonna. Hi. We're gonna find out more about Coca-Cola and how it's made.
We're in the secret vault.
Yeah, we're in the vault.
Let's go. We're going on a secret investigation.
Look at it. You have your binoculars on?
The world of Coca-Cola.
Always Coca-Cola.
Yeah.
What's the Tyrese commercial?
Those are different Turners. Tart and sweet, spicy and mild, sharp and silky, crisp to rich, tingly to smooth. So this is like you move this around in order to make those different tastes. Yeah, go ahead, try it. How you doing there, sir?
I'm spectacular. Hello, I can feel my sugar rush kicking in.
We haven't even had that much.
I had a bottle already.
Oh, you did?
A whole one, yeah.
Oh my goodness, really, babe?
You know, look, we paid for the city pass. Drinking everything.
Oh my goodness.
We don't drink, so we gotta drink this.
Yeah, we don't. Y'all, this is crazy. Oh, very cool, pumpkin. Look, this is what Liberty mixed up over there.
Dad, I solved it.
Yeah, we don't drink pop at home. We don't buy it at all. So.
Oh, look, right here, they're talking about the imposters.
Oh, wow.
That's, I guess, try to duplicate the Coke recipe.
He tried to lock the secret formula without helping us to find the clues. That's the game.
Your turn.
Get in, Mama. We need to pick her. All right.
Come on, let's go together. Let's fist together.
Ooh. Oh, that is so cute. I love it.
Raise your hand for not your avatar. I start to keep moving your hand. You can find the clues, so the clue we find. You can see the top right of the video screen. We got 5 clues down, 6 clues.
It's a public company since 1985, you know, more than 2, but we don't know how many because they got a board of directors. Some of them know about the secret formula, some of them know how, but we don't know. This is the pin note because you know the biometric hand scan?
Yeah.
The only one who can open it is the CEO.
The CEO.
But you see the pin number?
Yeah.
I hardly change every day.
You have to every day
the password change.
Wow.
Yeah,
wow.
But we don't know, you know.
So it's really on in there?
It's in there, yes. In 2011. True. Look at this. I'm at the Boy Scout, you see? True. All right, my friend.
Interior defects. Basically, make sure there's no glass inside the box. Wow, look at the machine. Oh, wow. Look at the robot.
That's a robot.
It's a robot, man.
It's a robot.
Wow. See, guys, this is just, this is so cool. We're so happy to be here and to have our daughter here for us. I mean, she's our little travel buddy. We couldn't see traveling without her. I mean, this, something like this, I mean, this is something she will never forget. This is really, I just wish more people would really try to make it happen without bringing their kids to travel with them. This is cool. You can't even explain something like this. Oh, look, we're on camera.
I All right, you all, here's the moment we've been waiting for. We are now in the tasting center, the tasting part of the world of Coca-Cola, and we will be tasting beverages, not only just Coca-Cola, but just different products of Coca-Cola from Africa, Asia, Europe, Latin America, and North America. So it's over, it's 100 plus beverages from all over the world. Let's go. It says enjoy the taste, skip the waste, please reuse your cup. So here we are, you guys, we are now in Asia. So look at all these different drinks. They have Fanta, look, they have, this is Veggie Tomato. This is from Japan, Hold on, Pumpkin, Thailand. We have Ramen, that's how you say it, Korea, India, China, Taiwan, Thailand. Oh my goodness, some of everything. Look at the flavors, apple kiwi, they have watermelon flavor. All right, let's see.
Tell us how you think about it.
All right, let's see. No, that's a pop. Hold on. Let's find something for Liv. Minute Maid. Here we go. Let's try that out and see.
All right, how is it?
What do you think? She hasn't stopped drinking yet, y'all. What do you think?
Yeah.
All right, I'm going to try this one. This one is Apple Kiwi Fanta from Thailand. Let's see. Very good. Apple kiwi, it tastes like green apple Jolly Rancher. Y'all remember those from back in the day?
Frosty. Get us frosty.
It's not good.
This one is apple and I love this. And I guess this and sweet. And you can taste it too. It tastes pretty good.
There's Africa right here. Let's go check out Africa.
Okay.
Okay, so the countries that are here are Uganda, Tanzania, Madagascar, Zimbabwe, Djibouti. I'm trying to say that without cracking a smile. South Africa, Mauritius, hold on, and South Africa. So we're gonna try Zimbabwe first. Liv's gonna try a little bit. All right, try it out. Tell me what you think. How is it?
It took us too long to answer. No. How is it?
Oh, it's like a sparkling, remember those 10 for 10 drinks that we'd be getting?
Oh, ice.
Ice, yeah.
Yeah. You want me to taste some?
Yeah.
Thank you.
How is it?
Oh, okay, it's very soft.
Soft.
Yeah, kind of tastes like candy, cheap candy. The gentleman downstairs said we need to try the Beverly, which is from Italy. So I'm about to try it and let's see how it is.
Tastes like iced tea. Hold on, I didn't try the Beverly. Oh.
Let me get your expression on the Beverly. This is the Beverly. My bad. Really bad. Super Mr. G-Man. He set us up. That gentleman set us up. We knew it was gonna be interesting taste.
It tastes like, I can't even say what this tastes like.
You
it
know what, like, what it smells like is some type of cleaning detergent.
Yeah, it tastes like Fabuloso.
Yeah. Yeah, we haven't had Fabuloso, but if we had to think about what it tastes like based
tastes
on
like
the taste.
Fabuloso smell.
Yeah. That is so interesting.
Liganberry, man.
Which one is that?
Liganberry, that's at IKEA.
Oh, we got that, yeah.
IKEA.
That's right. All right, you guys, we have made it to the end of the tour. We are all sugared out. We are ready to eat now. We are in the gift shop right now. We're just gonna burn through. We might be able to find a magnet, you know. You know, they give you all this drinking and they wanna get you all so you can spend all this money. It's not gonna happen with us, but we're excited to have shared this experience with you guys, and we will see you at our next location. All right.
me a jumper, show me a jumper. I mean, don't throw it up though, but show me a jumper. You're about to have a stop.
Trying to see how we can make it work. We definitely don't want to be in Houston.
Well, move here then. That's not too far. Move here. No, don't. Just leave. I mean,
and then
the
this
baby
is considered East Coast, right? I mean,
no, this is
Eastern Seaboard. Because I mean, Carolina, New York, you know.
Yeah. Just like, okay, you got Georgia, you have Texas, you have Louisiana, you have Florida, you have.
Right.
And then it's like, yeah, it's not too far. Let me get her bear.
Shit.
No. Okay. That's our postcard.
That's
we
our
just
bag.
Found.
Here, your surprise bag is inside of the bag.
Yeah.
$1.99 upsell bag. they done upsold it. Y'all feel for it.
The only reason why I said it, y'all, is because Liv's birthday. And I said, you know what, let's
surprise.
See what's inside. It's a souvenir.
Guys, I'm going to see what's in the bag.
Okay. Let's see what they done upsold us. Better be something good, too. Oh, a Coca-Cola bottle opener. Okay.
All right. Okay.
I used to be a soda bottle, is what that says. Oh, cool. You gonna put it around your neck?
I'm gonna put it on
my neck. Well.
All right.
Good job. All right. And your most. Okay guys, so we have made it to the surprise that we have for our daughter Liberty. It was the Georgia Aquarium. So many of you may know or you may not know, but Georgia Aquarium is the largest aquarium in the United States. We've been here one time before, and when I tell you they have a gigantic blood whale, like the big ones that you see the tail flapping out the water, they have one of those in here. I have no idea how they got it here. But it's an incredible, incredible aquarium. All kinds of stuff is inside. We haven't eaten yet, but we want to knock this out first and then we'll go get something to eat. So are you excited, Liberty? Look at her, she's dancing around. She can't help herself.
Okay, we won't go too close, sorry. Look, wow. not being here with us. Oh, are these catfish? Yeah, look, rip tall catfish.
Ooh, catfish.
Oh, mama, you know mama will be ready for this with you, babe.
I put you on a grill so fast, it'll make your head spin.
Wow, look at that.
I like a bear cook.
Mama, look at the eel, look at the eels down here.
I see
that stingray. Stingray, you got it, smart girl.
Look, I see that turtle.
I know. See, we had the yellow belly one, and then he got a little big, and we had to get rid of him. And this is, they get pretty big, guys, so we had to get rid of him not too long ago. But I do miss our turtle from time to time.
I do too.
This one's just short.
I can see his moving because he's awake because of all the talking.
Alright guys, we're at the piranha exhibit. When I tell you I would hate to be the person in charge of cleaning this tank out, we were just reading some of the facts and it was saying that piranhas can tear through a tuna within 5 freaking minutes. So, needless to say, you don't want to get stuck in something like that at all.
I mean, they don't even look real. This looks like a picture almost. This is so cool.
Wow. And it kind of looks like a statue.
Oh, and this is called a rockfish. It says these fish rock and roll in the shallow water from the Olympians to California. Like a rainbow rockfish species come in a wide variety of colors. How many different rockfish do you see, Liberty? How many do you see? They come in different colors.
I see one.
Two, and four, excellent. Wait, hold on, look, I think that's an octopus. Oh, it does look like one, doesn't it? Yeah, that's also a sea star, sea creature.
So we're at the secret
treasure. Wow.
Very good job, right, Pumpkin. Here. Let me see. Excellent.
Those are
so unique looking.
I love sea dragons. Mm-hmm. Why are they moving so slow?
They're just gliding.
They're taking it easy.
Yep, just relaxing.
Crawl through like penguins, let's go.
Daddy, I feel a little bit scared, but we can do it.
Yeah, you're gonna be in the middle. Daddy's in front, Mommy, you're in the middle, and I'm in the end. Let's crawl in. Oh my goodness. This is so cute.
Slow down, little people.
Uh-oh. Let me see, I'm a squat. Yeah.
Hold on. Let me see,
penguin. Dude, don't stand up so you don't touch your head. Ooh, you got all my booty, don't you?
No, I don't have it, really. I don't just have it like
that.
Oh,
my booty.
Really, babe?
My booty. Oh.
We're penguins.
What an experience. I couldn't imagine being here without you, babe, and our darling.
I know. All right, Liberty. Okay, here's the penguin. Here's one penguin. We go in the penguin hole.
Uh-oh.
Here's one penguin. We go in the penguin hole. In the penguin hole.
Look, I'm in.
You in there, babe?
Liberty, come see one.
Wow. This is so cool. We're in a hole, you guys. This is dope. This is hilarious. How you doing, babe?
You know you gotta crawl before you can walk.
Amen. Brown.
I'm hungry.
You
Look
are
at
not
you eating everybody's peanuts from the plane.
All the cashews.
All the pig feet. All the hog malt.
I am pooped. What about you, babe?
Yes, very much so.
And we're not even done with the aquarium. I know, we're not even finished.
I am pooped. And I am hungry.
We just got out of our cardio in with the penguin exhibit.
That was a tough tunnel.
Hello. And then you know what? Thank you, beautiful. And you, thank you. Oh my goodness, it's 7:40. And you know, like whenever we were going down, it actually went down. It like it sloped, you know.
That was really nice what the lady said to us at the gift shop.
I know, I was just thinking about that, like how nice it was for her to, you know, mention to you. She was like, you know, you have your wife, you have your daughter, you know, you guys should go ahead and just move on down to that ladder. It was kind of funny. She was just like, yeah, come on. Like, it's that simple, but it was so kind of her to say that. And even with her mentioning the fact that, you know, we only have Liberty, and she was like, oh yeah, you guys are like good. You know, you should come on down, you know, because most people, you know, are always constantly asking us questions about having our only child and when you guys want to have another one or you guys want to have more kids, and as if it's an issue or something like that, you know. So it was really refreshing to meet someone like that. It was almost, you know, God doesn't make any mistakes, I feel, in situations like that. So I feel like it was God just putting his peace on us about that whole situation, you know. So we look forward to exploring more and just kind of seeing what Atlanta has to offer. You know, in the meantime, we are happy being the three amigos.
So could you see being here so far?
You know what? Possibly. I think I could. Possibly. Oh, there's Onyi. I think I definitely like the southern hospitality that is here, like we have in Texas. But it seems even more richer, I think, you know. I've walked by many people and people are just speaking. They're kind. And Libby's getting attention as usual. She's always getting attention everywhere we go. So that's been a blessing, you know. But just people seem kind and like, you know, you need me to do this and you need me to do that. I don't know. It's like, it's a possibility.
So, Mr. O, since you have all these questions for me,
yeah.
I wanted to ask you back, you know, could you possibly see us being here in Atlanta?
Yeah, I could so far.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we've been to several places so far this year, and something about Atlanta is just kind of drawing me in. I don't know what it is. This is like our third time here, and we talked about it a few times, how I felt like it wasn't very diverse here, aka there's a bunch of black folks here, which is a positive in one sense, but we do like diversity, so we want to make sure if we do settle on here that, you know, it's not overly saturated in any particular field, because we both could do, you know, we could find jobs here fairly easily. But, you know, I just want to make sure, because we are very much about our culture. Our culture is super important to us, but we do also appreciate that we live in a melting pot here in Houston, back in Houston, not here in Houston. And so we just want to make sure it's a good balance of everything, you know. But mm-hmm. We do want to make sure that it's going to be the right move. You know, we're very, very strategic when we do things. So I don't want to change that. I mean, it's worked so far.
Wonderful. I love you.
Love you.
Can't live in.
How are you enjoying yourself?
Man, this is awesome. It's really wonderful. You know, I've said it a few times, I think, you know, we've been here before. It's just like coming back is just so beautiful. Like you could literally sit here. They have seats right here. It's like a step that you can sit on. And you could probably be here for hours just observing, you know, God's creation, you know. It's like really cool. And like Libby is so excited, as you guys have seen. She's so happy to be here. And it just makes, you know, Babe and I feel just awesome. You know, she's thanked us a million times, hugging out my leg. Thank you, Mommy. Thank you, Daddy. This is really cool. This is stuff that I was telling Babe earlier, like, I think it's like $35, I want to say, for adults, and then like maybe $29.99 for kids. And also him, it's like so worth it. I mean, we got like the city pass, so of course it was a combined price of all the things we're gonna do, but it's so worth it. Like, you get your money's worth. We've been here probably, let me see, it is now 8:35, and I want to say we got here maybe at, I don't know, about 6 o'clock. So we've been here 2.5 hours now, and like, we could still be here.
Where are they at? Oh, I see. Oh my goodness gracious. That thing is massive, Liberty. Yes, I see. So Liberty, tell us what you're enjoying about yourself time here.
I can't believe I'm enjoying myself.
That's a nice picture.
I see that big otter fish. That's coming right to me. I can't believe I keep seeing a lot of fishies.
There's so many here. That's why it's called an aquarium.
That's right.
I see some more.
I can't believe I see a lot of big fishies. It's a lot.
Daddy, look, that one looks like he's mad at us.
Which one? The shark?
Systems, then they were flown UPS.
Wow.
It's like over like a 30-hour journey.
Wow.
Then they landed here at the Hartsfield Airport.
Uh-huh.
Then UPS had some big diesel trucks. Uh-huh. They put them on the back of the diesel truck.
Wow.
Drove it up here to downtown Atlanta, and you have a crane and a hatch. Yeah,
wow.
That can just pick the whole thing up and then lower it into this area.
Wow.
Now that was when they were 10, 11 feet long. Now they're too big for that.
Wow.
So this is their forever home.
This is their forever
home. But we are excited because UPS did that whole thing for free.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Wow, that is amazing.
Because everybody's like, ooh, I get my name on something, so.
Okay.
So how long do they generally live?
We don't actually know.
Okay.
That's one of the reasons why they're here, so we can study them.
Mm.
They used to have some ideas about how old they thought different whale sharks were, but apparently they're reassessing that, so we're not sure.
Okay.
We do know that these guys are not yet ready to make more whale sharks, but we hope for that in the future.
Are they're considered young, or is it because
these are juveniles.
Wow.
So how big do they get?
So like an average length of a whale shark would be 33 feet.
Jesus.
So that would be about half the size of this window. Crazy. This window is 63 feet.
Wow.
So how big are they now?
Right now, the males are between 18 to 20 feet.
Wow.
And the females are a little longer. They're between 20 and 22 feet.
Wow.
So we expect them to grow at least another 10 feet.
Wow.
Insane.
Oh my goodness.
So I was going to ask, so how come the sharks don't attack the other fish that are in here?
So for the most part, we keep all of our sharks well fed. Now, the whale sharks, of course, like we were talking about before, their mouth is only, the throat's only this big,
yeah.
So they really can't swallow anything in here. But the smaller sharks, there is occasional unscheduled snacking, but it's normally a fish that's sick. or like if something wrong with your skin.
The
good sharks are actually kind of the darlings of the sea. They'll peck off anybody that like the acrylic in different areas. That happens usually in the morning time in this habitat, okay. But every day.
Okay. And how many gallons is all this water?
So in this habitat, you got 6.3 million gallons of water. In the entire aquarium, it's around 10 million gallons of water, but clearly most of it's right here.